Alrighty, Aries, Taurus, cusp. Solid control, power, unstoppable. When heart, mind, to a undertaking. In pretty much rushes in and attacks life straight on. Let me see, attacks life straight on. It's pretty much Aries, Taurus, cusp is power. They're unstoppable. Heart, mind, to a undertaking, rushes and attacks life straight on, are powerful individuals, plow through difficulties, comes out winners. Mars, Venus. Aries is Mars, Taurus is Venus. War, fight for what is right, not backing down, is a fighter and a lover. Born between two zodiac signs. They have overcome the weakness, quite on IQ and different from the others. Aries, vibrant, headstrong. Taurus tends to be more reserved towards introversion. Symbolizes sacrifice. Looks before leap, loves sports, physical activity, competitive, energetic, does not let obstacles to hinder from reaching their goals. Strong-minded, has psychic abilities, known to be very talented and passionate, fiery, stubborn tendencies, make admirers fume with jealousy. Aries, Taurus, cusp, called twins. They share qualities with Pisces and Gemini. Aries, Taurus, cusps are independent thinkers, not afraid to do their own thing or their own way. So pretty much you are dealing with somebody who is very, very powerful that you're not going to step in their way. They will fight you. And you cannot budge them. And they already know their weaknesses. They know their strengths. They already know their weaknesses. And if you try to step on their toes, or if you try to step in the way of their goals, they're not going to let it phase them. They're going to do their goals, and they're not going to let you hinder them. So pretty much you got, if you're an Aries, Taurus, cusp, solid control, power. You're two zodiacs right here. That's what a cusp is. You're unstoppable. You rush. Undertaking attacks life straight on, meaning that if there is a trouble, you're heading into it. Pretty much Aries is the ram, Taurus is a bull. You're not going to be able to control this person. They're unstoppable. They're going to do what they're going to do, and there's no way that you're going to be able to tell this person, like, if you try to give them difficulties, they will plow right through you. Like, if you're in their way, they will knock you down, and they will come out winners. And has quite an IQ and different from others. So these people are very on IQ and very different from others. A lot of people are not going to understand people with Aries, Taurus, cusp. They're not going to be able to understand it. Yes, they are fighters and they are lovers. And they love sports. They are very competitive, they are stubborn, and they have fire to them. So I believe you're dealing with one feisty individual that does their own thing. You're not gonna be able to stop them in any way. Psychic abilities. They are known to be talented and passionate. So, what I mean by passionate is that they are a lover and they are a fighter. Mars is war. Venus is love. Fire is Aries. Earth is Taurus. So pretty much you got a mixture of two of like pretty much you're born with two zodiacs. You're so talented. You're probably loved and admired so much that your admirers with jealousy. So let's say that you're with somebody and they're jealous of it. It's ridiculous. Stop that shit. It's childish. You are born between two zodiac signs if you're a cusp. You're two zodiacs the day you were born. Taurus is more like a slow paced. They're not gonna move until they wanna move. They're the ones who are in control. You don't budge them, you can't move them. And if you try to bring Aries conflict, they'll just go straight forward and wanna fight you. And the funny thing is that when you're 3 years old, because I remember looking it up, you're Aries, right? But you don't know this as a child till you get older enough to understand this and look it up yourself. You're 3 years old. You are Aries. But then there's a complete change to you. You will start having bullish energy. Meaning that you are Aries, but you're gonna be having Taurus energy. You're gonna start having the type of not being told what to do. You're gonna shut the fuck up. You can't move me. You're gonna have an attitude. That's where it's coming from when you're 3 years old. And that's what a cusp is. But like I said, you're two zodiacs in one. That's a cusp. You're both. It's very difficult when you find out that you have up to 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You're six cusp. Because this is the day you were born. That's one cusp. Then you got the fourth house. Is a cusp. Then you got a 10th house, you're a cusp. You're gonna be all confused with your energy. And that would explain it. That you're not gonna tolerate shit. You're gonna be feisty. And Taurus is more of a calm, harmonious, like chilled, relaxed energy. See, but Aries is more like, I'll fight you, I'm gonna fuck you up. Fuck you, try me. Taurus is more like on the side of, okay, calm down, relax. You don't have to jump into everything. See, there's a difference of your personality as well. And I think it's kind of cool that there is a book that helps to understand the secret of your birthday is. Now, it's kind of difficult when you got up to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 cups in you. That's going to be a little difficult to handle or to understand. Maybe there's a reason for it, but like I said, Aries is more like, I'm gonna fuck you up, fuck you, I'll fight you, get out of my way. Taurus is more like the calmer lover, the pretty much, you can't really bully a Taurus, okay? You really can't, because they don't care. You're not budging them. You can't. But once you get an Aries and Taurus cusp going, it's gonna bump heads. That pretty much you started something you shouldn't have. And that's what it probably means by this energy is unstoppable. If somebody wants to have goals, wants to achieve goals, wants to do better in life, and you try to stop them or try to stagnate them, they're going to step on you. They're going to step all over you or beat you up. Or they're going to fuck you up. That's just my opinion on how I feel about Aries, Taurus cusp. But the weird thing is that you also got twins, too. I didn't realize. The twins is that you share qualities with Pisces and Gemini. Now, I believe this is where the weaknesses are. That has to do with you being an Aries Taurus, but you're called a twin because you share the qualities with two other zodiacs. I believe the weaknesses is Pisces and Gemini. Is the weaknesses between Aries and Taurus cusp. I could be wrong, I don't know. But there are people that are going to be jealous, admirers of Aries and Taurus. And who's jealous of the zodiac signs? Pisces and Gemini. So it's kind of weird that if you figure out your birth chart, your whole self, you figure out, okay, you're Aries, Taurus, or whatever cusp you are, and you find out, oh, this is why, well, the reasons why I say it's funny is because there was an ex of mine that texted me, and I knew it was him. I said, what the fuck you want, pretty much, and he wouldn't tell me who he was, and I knew exactly who he was. So, you know, it was actually kind of weird that he drove by my home and he saw me with Cody and he just went fucking berserk in the car, threw his hands up, like threw in a fucking fit. That's jealousy right there. Geminis are known to be jealous, okay? And then Pisces have a weird way of being jealous. They will, like, stalk you in a weird way. Like, I don't know if it's, like, emotional hurt. But that's what I'm saying, though. When you are a Aries, Taurus, cusp, your admirers are going to be jealous that you're not with them. And I know that sounds a little fucked up. But that's what it seems like. These people don't even understand if they're a cusp or a one Pacific sign. You're dealing with two planets of energies, because there for a long time I was really curious, so I started looking up my birth chart and I go, okay, and then all of a sudden I came across Aries Taurus cusp, and then I said, well, before I looked at that, I said, damn, I love food a lot. I really do, like, I love food half to death. It's not funny. And then come to find out later on that Taurus is the type that loves food. So then I'm thinking, okay, I found that out. And then later on, a couple years later, I found out, came to Aries, Taurus, cusp. Now I get it. Why people are saying that when you're unstoppable, that's what they probably mean. You're probably a Aries Taurus cusp. That's the house of solid control power. Pretty much. You're going to be feisty. And you're going to be stubborn as fuck. You are going to be stubborn and feisty to you. But you also probably, what I think is negative, is that you got a twins. And this is why you have to look up everything, because it's very confusing. And you have to know what you're talking about. And it takes a while before you can understand the birth chart, or even to try to explain it. There's all different angles you have to look at. So what I think is that when it says negative or the twin, okay, think about it. Aries and Taurus is your cusp. Think about it. There's always a positive and a negative. I think your negative is your twin, would be Pisces and Gemini. And it's kind of funny because it explains a lot that I didn't realize Aries use intuition. They also have psychic abilities. Taurus uses sensuality. They use common sense. So if you're dealing with somebody that's an Aries, Taurus, that's why a lot of people go, I wouldn't screw with that person, or you're not stopping this person. This person thinks that they're unstoppable. Well, guess what? God put this in your book the day you were born. Some people don't even believe this, but this is how you understand tarot. This is how you understand your birth chart and astrology and numerology. It all has to do with this, your aspects too, which aspects are very difficult for me, but somehow I figured out there's a Scorpio moon in the mix. But like I said, this is actually funny because this symbolizes sacrifice. Think about it. Your Aries is ruled by Mars, and your Venus is ruled by Taurus. You got war, passion, wrath, anger, frustration. And then Venus is more love, compassion, understanding, takes their time, and don't leap into shit. Like, they're very slow people when it comes to certain shit. They don't rush in like Aries does, which I've noticed that. Which, that's very funny. But like I said, Aries is very strong-headed and vibrant. That there's a lot that you can understand by looking up yourself. And yeah, these people come out as winners. And these people will plow through difficulties and come out as a winner. I believe it's maturity level and what you know. And if you're getting the proper intuition, or you're intuitive, or you're getting the right gut intuitions. I believe it's maturity level, but everybody is different. But like I said, these people know how to overcome their weaknesses. So I'm thinking, if Aries, Taurus is a cusp, you're two signs in one. You were born with two signs. Okay? Where is it at? Yeah. And Aries, Taurus, cusp are independent, and they are thinkers. They're thinkers. And then think about this too. Pisces and Geminis are not much thinkers. They're more of playing with the emotions. Gemini is more like tricking you instead of being genuinely passionate. So that's what I believe. That's what they mean by your twin. Okay, let's say for an example that you had a... I don't even know how to explain this. Let me see. Let me grab my book and let me give an example really quick. It may not be right on track, but I'm trying to give an example. Okay, let's say that you had Sagittarius, Capricorn, for an example, as a cusp. And then you got your fourth house, you got your 10th house. Let's say that you're a Sag and Capricorn cusp. There's twins that are possibly the negative side of the zodiac. That's what I believe. And like I said, a lot of people don't understand. They're saying, well, cusp people don't matter. Yeah, it does. Because if, like, I didn't even know it. I didn't realize I was a Aries Taurus cusp until I confirmed it with a book. It's literally the secret language of birthdays. It shows I'm about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cusp with a lot of energies. But not everybody on their birthday is going to be a cusp. So that's why you got the 4th house, you got the 10th house. I'm pretty sure your 4th house and 10th house, you're going to be a cusp regardless. Because that's what I looked up. That your cusp is going to be in the 4th house and it's going to be in the 10th house. And it's a rare occasion if you got it the day you were born. You were born both zodiacs. You just got to figure out which one's which. And I've already kind of explained which one's which. Like I said, Aries is more the fuck you up. Taurus is more like the chill out, relax, not really caring, you can't budge me, fuck off pretty much, I don't give a damn, fuck you. Taurus is a earth sign. They're a bull. That's why they're stubborn. Aries is, okay, Aries is stubborn where they want to fight you. Taurus is stubborn that they do at their own pace. And if you try to fight them both, they're going to ram into each other and you're in for a lot of trouble. But this is my opinion. Yeah, you were born between two zodiac signs. And I just wanted to quickly say my opinion. But I think it's really cool when people start looking up about themselves. I think it's pretty cool. Very interesting. But like I said, I also might look up something else too, but I'm not 100% sure. My brain's been going constantly. Been thinking a lot. But like I said, I just thought that maybe this is cool. Talk about cusp. Because it is a real thing. And if you get the proper good book of the secret language of birthdays, and you know an astrology book, and you know for sure it's in there, they can't say shit that cusp don't matter, because it does. Because it has to do with your personality. It has to do the day you were born. It does matter. And yes, it is a real thing. Like I said, not everybody's going to be a cusp. Maybe, like I said, in the 4th house, yes. 10th house, yes. You're possibly going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 cusp. But there's a rare occasion where you're 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's a rare occasion when you're all 6 different cusp. It's a rare occasion. And also, it is a rare. You're pretty much on IQ. People don't understand this personality traits. It's very, you're different from others. A lot of people may not understand you. It's very unique and very cool, very different. But like I said, I might look up something else too because it's pretty cool. But I'm going to go and get off here.